Have you ever struggled with choosing and creating adequate exterior lighting scenarios? Who doesn't, right? But don't worry, as today, we'll talk about different kind of lighting you can choose when creating an exterior image. Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. If you are new here, my name is Aga and I'm a CG artist. And on this channel, we explore techniques and tools that will help you become a better artist. Today, we are exploring the exterior lighting topic in detail, so I hope that after this video, you will not struggle anymore. But before we start, don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you aren't already, so you won't miss any future tutorials. So, as we all know, lighting is one of the top things we need to consider when creating any visualization, simply because there is no scene without lighting, there is just a black render. Okay, so let's talk about the options we have when creating an exterior image. So in general, we can divide exterior lighting into a couple of categories. So first of all, we have natural lighting, that is the light from the sky, sun and moon. And here we have different periods of times that gives us different effects. We have golden hour, which is the period after the sunrise and before sunset. Let me show you some examples. To create this kind of image, we can use a backdrop image of the sky and set a similar lighting setup, meaning creating similar lighting effects, colors and softness in 3D software. On the other hand, we can also use HDRI with the sun linked to it. If you want to know how to set up the HDRI in 3ds Max, I put the link to the video where I show how to do this in the corner. So the time in the morning when the sun appears, or time in the afternoon when the sun disappears. In this case, the sun is quite low. And to create a really nice natural lighting scenario, we can use only sun and sky from the render engine we have. I put the link to the corner to the video where I show you how to create this sort of lighting. Blue hour instead is the time before sunrise and after sunset. In terms of the blue hour, we can use only the sky. However, much better effects will be achieved by using HDRIs, as in this example. We can also extract mid-morning and afternoon. So it's the time when sky casts more a subtle yellow light that eliminates harsh shadows. We can achieve really great results with just using the sky and sun. However, the position of the sun towards the subject will be crucial as the light from the sun adds atmosphere and character to the visualization. We also have midday, which is the time between 11 a.m. and 1 p.m. And typically, it's not the best time to choose for the exterior shots. And I don't really have any examples of this. However, it can work pretty well in the interiors, but it's not the subject of today's video. And finally, the night, when the sunlight is absent. So like in this example, we can create a city image that has lots of artificial light included, but environmental light is sort of the base to all of this. If you have lots of glass materials, it's good to use HDRIs with clouds to add nice reflection to these parts. By the way, this image is part of our advanced exterior visualization course, so I put the link in the corner in case you want to check it out. Okay, but except of natural lighting, we also have different kinds of artificial lighting. So let's talk about this now. So first of all, we have an ambient lighting, also known as general lighting, that provides an area and overall outdoor lighting. So it should give a comfortable level of brightness to see and walk safely in real life. So, for example, exterior wall lights can have this function like here. Or like in this example. Lots of the time, interior lighting becomes ambient lighting for the exterior. Or like here, a combination of both. And Another one is the so-called task lighting that, as the name says, is used for performing a specific task. So task lighting lights a particular area and makes completion of the task easier. So in contrast to the ambient light that illuminates a general area. So let me show you an example. For instance, dual light that makes opening doors easier in the night. Or another example can be step lights. So simply lighting up the steps to make it easier to walk in the dark. And of course, we also have the accent lighting that adds character and drama to the outdoor space. The role of this light is to add visual interest. For example, it can be lighting up the planting, like here, or like in this example, or some architectural details, like the wall in these cases. Now, there are some lighting techniques that help in producing beautiful exterior images. So it's placing the lights at the base of an object we want to lighten up and pointing the light up at this particular object. We can also use a technique called silhouetting, which is basically placing the light behind the object, targeted towards the wall next to it, in order to create an illuminated backdrop for this object. Next one, shadowing. Let me show you. In contrast to the silhouetting, we need to place the light in front of the object, focusing the light through the object to the wall next to it. This is a great example as well. It creates such a nice effect. Similarly here. Now, another method, wall washing. It is another technique in which vertical indirect lighting is placed in the ceiling or the floor at a wider distance from the wall. The goal is to achieve an equal subtle lighting that provides a sort of a washed effect of the wall. And finally, we have moonlighting that, as the name says, simulates the moonlighting. Let's see. To create the effect, we need to use a light with a full glare guard. So we place this light somewhere on top of the tree and target it downwards. Thanks to this, we can get a very natural effect spread over a large area. I'd like to mention here that the best technique is to use layering effect, so adding different kinds of lights to your image. Let's analyze it on the example. I think it will be nicely visible on the hotel shot. Let's see. So first of all, we have an environmental light that it's not directly visible, but it's visible in the reflection. So it's good to use HDRI in this case to create a more interesting look. Additionally, we have lighting from opposite buildings that are reflected in the glass brick facade. The lighting from the interior of the lobby becomes an ambient light for this exterior shot. However, it also has another role. It helps composition. We also have the task lighting in the form of the lobby canopy spotlights that make it easy to go to the main entrance, but also it highlights the most representative part of the building. Additionally, we also have accent lights in the interiors from lamps and behind the mirror objects in the restaurant and lobby dusk lights. Glimpses of light in the hotel rooms add extra character to the building facade, depth to the image, and adds life to it. And finally, we also have an accent light in the form of the car lights that helps composition and guiding the viewer for the image. So you can see that images that catch attention typically use advanced techniques of adding lighting, like layering effect, balancing it with shadows, but also using lighting to help composition. So if you like to learn how to create this image from start to finish, I'd like to invite you to check out our advanced exterior visualization course, where we will teach you step by step how to create images like this. Plus, there are plenty of bonuses and discounts. Click here to check it out on our website. Bye-bye!